declaration of martial law.
Martial law is considered one of the darkest episodes in Philippine history. Thousands detained, tortured, and killed in a sweeping crackdown engineered by the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos. Not to mention the huge fortune amassed by his family and cronies from public coffers. But still, there are those like Father Anilo Aquino who prefer to listen to the other side of the story, the so-called other narratives about the Marcos regime. Even if much of the debate has been pretty much settled with hard facts.
Yes, there are facts, and I'm not going to say there were no victims. There were victims. There have been court convictions affirming the abuses of martial law. But there are also stories told by those who support him. And my only desire is that when we tell this grand story about what a dictator he was, let us not forget that there are other narratives that might also be heard if we don't have any interest in listening to them now. In due time, they should also be heard.
On Marcos's birthday last September 11, the priest caused quite a stir when he tweeted that the present generation that is loud in its condemnation of Marcos never experienced his regime. So the rant, he said, was directed at their construct of Marcos. For good measure, he told them to read two important French philosophers more.
But you are not a revisionist. That's what I want to clarify. You're not advocating revisionism.
I'm not a revisionist is one who changes the facts. A revisionist is one who says that good is bad and bad is good. That's not my point.
But here lies the problem with bringing the discourse to mere constructs.
The tweet also creates the false impression that there is a that only the present generation is condemning Marcos. There are still survivors of the martial law generation very much around who are protesting against the continued power and influence of the Marcoses. They think, we think, because we've been through it, we don't want the reality of our experience to be negated or denied in mental constructs.
Human rights activist Carlos Conde says the brutality and corruption under Marcos are a fact, not a matter of opinion. Those who try to spin or finesse it are insulting the memory of the thousands of victims. For people like Conde, there's a raging battle against revisionism, especially since, despite the Marcos's downfall in 1986, it's not like they actually lost their power and wealth. Christian Esguerra, ABS-CBN News.